Please welcome to the program Maziar Bahari.
Maziar Bahari is a Canadian-Iranian journalist who was imprisoned by the Iranian Revolutionary Guard for 118 days. It is the subject of a brand new film, Rosewater, where he's played by Gael Garcia Bernal and directed by The Daily Show's Jon Stewart. And it's a film that, at least in part, is motivated by Stewart's guilt.
When did your relationship with The Daily Show begin?
I was in Iran in the first month of 2009 in order to cover the presidential election in June 2009. I was being interviewed by different news outlets, and among them, producer of The Daily Show. So we went to a cafe, he pretended to be a spy, he introduced me as Agent Pistachio.
As a spy, I'm just trying to figure out why your country is so terrifying.
And then when I got arrested, they wanted to send a message to many journalists and filmmakers working in Iran, and they charged me with espionage. They called me a media spy. And in the absence of any real evidence, they brought forward ridiculous evidence, including my appearance on The Daily Show.
He's not a spy.
He's not a spy?
It's a show.
It's a show?
A comedy show. It's stupid.
It's very stupid, yes.
He's a comedian pretending to be a spy.
So can you tell me why an American pretending to be a spy had chosen to interview you?
And why would a real spy have a TV show?
I never thought that they would be so ignorant and stupid, but I learned something new.
At a certain point, you gave a televised confession.
My name is Maziar Bahari. I'm a documentary filmmaker, a journalist.
When you see that footage now, what goes through your head?
It was as if I was publicly raped and taped, and having the tapes on YouTube, because you're constantly exposed to that footage of seeing yourself being humiliated, being tortured, being abused on television.
Stand up. We are here now.
One of the things that is not very much in the film is the amount of physical torture. Talk me through the decision to go in that direction.
The physical torture that I suffered and many other people suffered, those happen often. But they are not the main order of business for torturers and interrogators. Many people who are in charge of the Iranian government right now, they were tortured themselves, so they know exactly what hurts. And according to new torture techniques, torture methods, physical torture can be counterproductive because the person who is being tortured can reach a state where he or she reaches a nirvana and thinks that he or she is invincible. So with psychological torture, you never reach any kind of threshold. They can torture you psychologically as much as possible in order for you to become delusional, suicidal, so they can be in charge of your life.
For people watching at home that don't have a lot of frame of reference for what we mean when we say psychological torture, can you walk us through perhaps what were the most effective techniques?
The worst kind of torture, physical and psychological torture, is solitary confinement, because you are deprived of all your senses. You cannot see anything except for the walls. You cannot touch anything except for the walls. So for me, in order to survive, I had to tap into my inner resources. I had to work on the book that I knew I was going to write.
You already knew you were going to write a book.
I knew that from the, to tell the truth, in the beginning I thought I was going to be there for 1 week. So I thought I was going to write an article called 1 week in Evan prison. Then it became 2 weeks and 3 weeks. So I thought I was going to write a book. All the humiliations, all the insults, beatings and everything, they were part of this book that I was going to write. So I think the message of the film is really that you should not arrest journalists because they remember things and they can write down things.
I'm a journalist, nothing more.